When it comes to planimetric surveying, our Virtual Surveyor app offers several ways to help make your workflow a fast and simple process. We'll show you some tools and methods that can greatly increase the speed at which you create your planimetric survey, like more efficient ways to draw items, the ability to quickly duplicate multiple items all at once, and easily adjust them to fit the project site. Let's get to it. Here, we have our planimetric project set up with some layers. And we're using a dataset that has lots of areas we can showcase some of the tools and features. First, we'll switch to 2D mode, then zoom in and start drawing. We'll draw our first paint stripe using the side first drawing mode of the rectangle tool, which is how this tool has always worked in the past. Click on two corners, then drag out to complete the rectangle. We can use our move copy tool to duplicate our work. To activate the tool, highlight your drawn item, then find and enable the Move Copy tool in the Home tab. You can now see a dotted outline of the drawn shape. You simply left-click where you want to make a copy of your selected item, and it is done. In this case, our drawn item is not properly aligned, and it's a little longer than the paint stripe. To fix the alignment, we can simply use the Move Copy tool to rotate our drawing into place, like so. With the alignment fixed, we can either leave the drawing as is, if the requirement is to keep the drawn lines the same size, or we can edit the size of the drawn item. To edit the shape of this rectangle, select the item, go to the Tools tab, and enable the Edit Side tool. This tool enables us to edit any side of the rectangle to either change its shape or the length of its lines. Just simply click and drag the line where you want to change, and voila! Another solution we have to speed up your drawing is to change how you initially draw your rectangle. We can use the diagonal first drawing mode, which, as you will see, allows us to very quickly and accurately produce the proper rectangular shape, without having to worry about the orientation of the surface. You simply click the opposite corners of the paint stripe and move your cursor until you get the appropriate rectangular shape. This can create a perfect fit every time. Now to speed things up even faster, we'll introduce you to the mini toolbar. If you right-click in the viewport, the mini toolbar will display, giving you quick access to the drawing tools that are normally found in the ribbon. Without any project items selected, we get the full range of drawing tools. When we select an item and right-click to access the mini toolbar, we get a small list of options to edit that item. We want to keep drawing these paint stripes, so we'll select Move Copy, and create a copy on the next paint stripe. Now just adjust as necessary, quickly rotate it, right-click, select Edit Side, and ensure the proper fit. Now that we've shown you the basic tools and features, we can go over some more situations where they can really help speed up your workflow. Another great application for using the diagonal first drawing mode is when drawing a drainage. And we can make quick work of them when combining tools. First, we'll enable the rectangle draw tool, ensure the diagonal first mode is selected, then draw out the outer square by clicking on opposite corners and dragging out the shape. Rather than drawing each square manually, we can go to the Tools tab and select the offset line tool. Simply drag out the shape, left-click to add the middle square, and left-click again to create the inner square. This is where we really start to speed up the drawing process. You can copy all three drawn squares simultaneously for the next drainage. To do this, hold Shift, then click and drag over your drawn drainage to highlight all the lines at once. Just like the paint lines, right-click to access the mini toolbar, select Move Copy, and create a copy on the next drainage. Rotate, move into place, and done. Then rinse and repeat for each drainage. This same method can be used for all your drawn items, which can drastically cut down the time it takes to complete a planimetric survey since you simply duplicate what you've already drawn. Now let's move to the parking lot and create some parking lines to see how we can compound duplicated items. To trace out the parking lines, it can really help to draw a guideline that makes it easier to align everything. You'll see how this helps with alignment in just a second. Now we draw our first line by snapping it to the guideline and extending it to the end of the parking line. Right-click for the mini toolbar and select Move Copy. Copy the next line by aligning it with the parking strip and snapping it to the guideline. We'll copy the next line in the exact same way. Now we can duplicate all three lines with the Move Copy tool, just like we did with the drainage. As you can see, where our cursor is in regards to where we place the lines will make it pretty difficult to properly snap to the guideline. This is called the anchor, and we can change its location on the drawing to make it so we place the duplicated drawing where we want it to be with the first click. In this case, we want the anchor to be at the bottom of the far left line so we can ensure it properly snaps all three lines to the guideline. We can compound our lines again by selecting six lines, adjusting the anchor, and copying all six to the next set of parking lines. After duplicating multiple drawn items, you may need to adjust some of the lines and touch up some areas. But with the tools we just showed you, it should be pretty easy for you to figure out the method that works best for your workflow. For parking islands, we have another method we'd like to show you that utilizes some of our other tools to help you speed up the drawing process even more. We'll switch to another dataset that can showcase this really well. With these parking islands, they have this symmetrical shape, and one next to them that is asymmetrical. With the tools available, we can use these symmetrical shapes to our advantage, and very quickly copy, edit, and fit the drawing to the asymmetrical island. To draw this island, we'll start with the Arc tool. To enable the Arc tool, make sure nothing is selected in the viewport. Right-click to bring up the mini toolbar and select Arc. We'll create two points, here and here, and move the cursor out to finish the arc with a click. Now, with the item selected, again we bring up the mini toolbar, select Move Copy, adjust the anchor, duplicate the item on the other side of the island, rotate and move into place as needed, and click to finish. Now we can select both arcs, right-click for the mini toolbar and select To Boundary to complete the shape. We'll make a copy on the next island and adjust where necessary. And done. Then we'll make another copy on the next asymmetrical island, access the mini toolbar, and this time select the Split tool. We'll split the drawing here and here. Then highlight the half of the drawing we don't need and just delete it. Now highlight the other half, bring up the mini toolbar, and select To Boundary again. And we're done. Now, not everything for planimetric surveying is just parking lots and drainages. We'll quickly switch datasets again to show you how beneficial these drawing tools are when tracing the footprint of a building. All right, here is the building we want to create a footprint for. Normally, we'd use the boundary tool to meticulously attempt drawing straight lines around the building. It works, but it is a bit clunky and rarely ever produces straight edge lines. So instead, we can select our rectangle tool and enable the drawing first diagonal mode. Then we can create a large square that lines up around the building's edges. This is a very different way of drawing the building's footprint, but it can be faster and will definitely create a cleaner drawing. Now we just access the mini toolbar to make adjustments to the edges, but this time we'll be using Edit Vertex to break up individual portions of the building's edges. Just add a vertex to this corner of the building, access the mini toolbar, select Edit Side, and move the edge into place. Again, rinse and repeat for each corner and edge of the building that needs to be drawn. Of course, you can always choose the drawing methods that work best for you when creating your planimetric survey. But hopefully, we've shown you some tools and features you will be able to incorporate into your workflow that can significantly help you save time. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us from our support portal. A huge thanks for tuning in. And as always, happy surveying.